Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, back with another kit review for you. This is a Hawk kit. Hawk is a very old model company. It was bought out by Lindbergh and a bunch of other people before it finally came into the hands of Round 2. And now Round 2 is putting out their kits again. I'm not sure if this kit is new old stock or where the place I got it from bought it from. It seems like it's newer packaging with newer pictures and everything, but I can't find any other online retailers that carry it. I didn't get it off eBay. I actually got it from Hobby Link, and they had a whole bunch of other Hawk kits on sale as brand new kits wrapped in plastic, so I'm not sure where they got them. Round 2 doesn't have any of them on their website, so these just must be new old stuff on the shelf that's never been opened and they're getting rid of. I paid less than $12 for this kit. This is like a Rube Goldberg kit, and they have quite a few of these different ones available, but you know I like model ships and all that stuff, so the first one I decided to try out was this Weirdos Wacky Contraptions Stranded Old Salt Flags a Ship, a weird and zany animated model kit. Now looking at the box, you can see it says it really works. It's made in the USA. It's got all this stuff in the box. Everything you see is in the box, and it's one of those Rube Goldberg kits. You make some, you pull a string, you move a weight, and then the kit starts to act out things for you. You can see it's got a hula lady, it's got a sign saying Leaky Boat Louie doesn't stand a chance saving this castaway sailor. Leaky Boat Louie is actually another Weirdos kit, and I do own it, so I'll be able to review that one for you as well. But you can see there's the old sailor with his binoculars. There's the monkey going up to the help sign, and the hula girl, and the chicken, the fish bones, all different kinds of neat stuff on here. And it even includes that palm tree. So let's take a look at some of the stuff that's in the box. One of the things that's in the box is this little coil of string that helps you make the parts move. They include it. If it breaks, it literally just looks like sewing string, so don't even worry about it. If you lose it or that breaks, you can replace it in 2 seconds. It includes this cool sign, and it tells you how to use the model kit. You can pause the video and it'll tell you exactly everything that it does. And then it includes that sign I showed you on the box. These are cardboard punch out that will go as part of the diorama when you're done. There is a one sheet manual. Open that up. You can see it's got just one large sheet printed on two sides. Tells you how to snap everything together, glue it, and then you would just paint it to look just like the box top. And it tells you how to operate the model as well, and how it should work once it's all assembled, where to put the signs, and so forth. Very simple, very straightforward. Definitely looks like an old-timer's kit, something that came out a long time ago. We could take a look at all the plastic that's in the box. This right here is the base. And it does have some accessory parts like a handle here to make the kit start doing its thing. And then you can see where everything interlocks into the base. So it's going to be, you know, what do we have here? 10 inches long and about 4.5 inches wide. So make a nice little diorama. It won't take up much more space than a model car. But it's definitely going to, you know, do more than a model car. People come over to look at your collection. You can actually make your kits do something instead of just making car noises as you run around on the floor and they check you into the funny farm. Another parts tree here is Mr. Monkey. And you can see on the one side, he has a sign that says, "Help." And he's going up. And then when the sign flips, see, it sits like so. It sits like so on this pole, and that's a round pole there. And it'll flip like this. And then it says, "Don't help," when the pretty hula lady starts dancing. In other words, the old fart on the stranded island wants to be rescued, and the minute she starts shaking her moneymaker, he decides to flip that monkey around, and he doesn't want any help. He tells him, "Don't help, go away." So it's minorly comical. There's the top of the palm tree. That does not look like the top of a palm tree. It looks like something else. These are the two parts that the weird looking hand and feet that make the stand for telling you the crazy chain of events and how to work the kit on the diorama. So that's that tree there. We got a lot of parts falling off. So we'll show you some of the loose parts. We got the hula skirt. with a nice molding. That's part of her skirt. You can see the attachment point to make her shake around and dance as I drop it on the floor. We've got part of the old Salt's binoculars with his hands. That's just the top half. We've got some parts of his arms here. These are all loose parts in the kit. You can see it's very much a caricature, and it's not going to be scale accurate. That's not something you can expect from this kit. This is what the dude looks like. That's each half of him. Very comical, very not lifelike, and it's not supposed to be perfectly lifelike for him. And then we have the Hula Lady, which is a lot nicer looking than the dude. Obviously, someone at Hawk figured, well, we'll put a little more detail into this part. Because when Dad was building this kit with the kid in the basement, this was the part that Dad got to work on. And then we've got the chicken. So they have fresh eggs while they're deserted, so it's not so bad. Beautiful woman and fresh eggs every morning. Here's the palm tree trunk, which is 3D, because that holds the sign for the monkey. There's a hand pointing. You've got a, what would you call that, a parrot or a toucan. And you got a fish bones as accessory parts on the diorama. And then you've got the coconut halves. There's actually another half that's in the bag still that I didn't take out because it came loose. And those are part of the weight system that swing back and forth. And then you've got the signpost here that holds up the sign about how Leaky Louie can't save him. And then you've got your crankshaft. And then other small parts to anchor all the different parts to the diorama. So all in all, this kit looks really cool. It looks like a lot of fun. You would just paint it to look exactly like it does on the box here. And you could, you know, if you used craft paints on this kit, you could get this done on a Saturday. I don't see any reason why not. You paint everything with craft paints. You dry it off with a hairdryer. Craft paint will dry almost instantly with a hairdryer. You could brush paint it, airbrush it, whatever you wanted to do. And you could have this thing assembled and screwing around and on your desk in one weekend easily. You know, probably even an entire Saturday or a Saturday and a Sunday if you want to take your time. So appreciate you guys taking a look at a wacky kit here. You know I like the oddball stuff, the different stuff. So thanks for watching. We'll see you at the next review.